Hello everyone, Paula.
Hola, que no sé cómo narices.
Sí, no, ya estás en directo.
Vale.
Okay.
Vale.
Put your camera if you don't mind, please.
Vale.
Okay. Yeah, sorry, we have a problem in the
yes.
Connection, okay? Okay, thank you very much to everyone. I think that you can hear or see us. Please confirm in the message. It's the moment for our speaker. For me, it's a pleasure to come with Dr. Laura García Borgoñón today. Laura García Borgoñón is a computer science engineering from the University of Zaragoza. She's a doctor in software engineering and technology from the University of Sevilla in 2016. She has more than 20 years of experience in the coordination and technical direction of technological scientific projects, both national and European. And she currently works at the ITA Innova, Technological Institute of Aragon, where she has carried out technical tasks and has head of the research line in the field of software engineering. She is currently a researcher technician in the area of digital technology. Laura has developed her research career and her doctoral PhD thesis in the field of model-driven engineering and process modeling language with the group of web engineering and early testing from the University of Seville. She also collaborates as a professor at the master's degree in software engineering and computer systems at the International University of La Rioja. She has publications in scientific journal of high impacts and collaborates as a reviewer in conference journal and so on in the IT field. Her main interests are focuses on improving software development through software engineering, model-driven software, automation of software development, application of agile development methods, and in the acquisition of thinking skills, computation in early age. Today, Laura is going to speak out about a project that I know very, very well. And I think that is directly related with the chain of our AST conference, this AST from Trenches. So Laura, it's your turn. Thank you very much for accepting the invitation. Thank you for your time. It's your time.
Thanks, Maria Jose, for the presentation. As he has already said, I'm Laura García Borgoñón, and I work at the Aragon Institute of Technology. In order to the reason of the origin of this talk, I would like to briefly introduce the Institute of and its function. The Aragon Institute of Technology is a public technology center located in Zaragoza, who is in the middle of Madrid and Barcelona, in the middle, in Spain, and it belongs to the government of Aragon, the regional government. It's a community into Spain. Its mission is to help the development of companies in the region. Our function is an innovation center, trying to bring companies closer to new trends and research and knowledge in different areas. Sometimes we are seen as a R&D department in enterprises. It's a multidisciplinary institute which covers different knowledge, mechatronics, robotics, materials and components, and so also software. In this field of software, our objective has always been to prove the competitiveness of companies in the region. In a way, we are a region outside of the middle of the main focus in IT enterprises, Madrid or Barcelona, and the survival of our companies goes through the creation of software quality products with efficiency and effectiveness. At ITA Innova, I have working for more than 20 years trying to improve the application of software engineering in small and medium enterprises through different projects. Some are large, like regional programs, which allow us to bring together a representative number of companies in Aragon. In these projects, the ability to help and improve is easier because our presentation and communication are shared between every companies. In other cases, we work in a specific and ad hoc projects with concrete requests for supporting small enterprises to solve a specific problem. Also, in this time, we have advices on several situations to the public company of Aragon that is in charge of managing the software development contracts and produce of the government in Aragon. In short, we act as advisor, in many cases as consultants, and in many other cases, we are support to call when they are disoriented. This, I would like to transmit this message. This message, in some way, serve as our mantra. In lifting others, we raise, because our mission is try to be the two steps ahead the company. Every time we can support to a company in these matters, and our satisfaction grows. I would like to highlight the two large regional projects that we have carried out in this time, which are Sofaragon and Testea. They were relevant enough to position us as reference point in software engineering within Aragon. Sofaragon was the first associative program in Spain which had CMMI as a reference model. It was an initiative of Government of Aragon that was implemented by Itainova during the years 2004 and 2011. The goal of this project was to improve the quality of software development processes in IT enterprise in Aragon, especially in small and medium enterprises. More than 100 companies in the region were involved in different ways. Some of these enterprises were IT, that is, their business was software development and software products. Others were informatic department within industrial enterprises, which were in charge of making software for their products. We achieved to interpret the requirements of a model such as CMMI, designed for large organization to very small companies with 6 to 7 workers, with aspiration for growth, and above all, a lot of interest in improvement. In those years, different activities were carried out: presentations, training, evaluation, workshops related at all CMMI process areas. Each of these process areas had its own complexity, but we detected that validation and verification, and also the relationship between test cases and requirements and their traceability in a project, were those in which it was one of the most difficult to know how to execute them. We saw that it was an area of working in which there was not enough knowledge or experiences among the people of Aragon's organizations. Therefore, a few years later, in 2015, we developed another large regional project. We named it Testea, like a joke between testing and the A of Aragon. The main objective of this project was to show the importance of testing, and so that testing problems are not specific for a company. On the contrary, many difficulties are common and shared between organizations. The project had four fundamental axes. We try to focus: discover, which allow us to know different standards like ISO and both national and international initiatives; imagine, where we wanted to act as catalyst in order to organization could consider its approaches testing in day-to-day so that it will provide greater value; share, because the fact of sharing experiences and approaches between small companies allow them for joint progress. This is something especially difficult in our region, because I don't know if it's because the climate also, but companies tend to be individual island. We all know each other, they look at each other, but they distrust. Then we had to work on the fact that joint growth, it could be good. And the last one was experiment. Through different workshops, we were closer to some researchers and products that some universities were carrying out at the time. We had the collaboration of the University of Seville, University of Oviedo, and Polytechnic University Valencia of Valencia through the PROS group. We greatly appreciated their time to them because we tried to go down into the trenches and meet people who were not researchers, but who were responsible for testing departments in software organizations that developed software products, understand some approaches which have been in research period yet. During the project, we also conduct a survey of testing situation in companies and prepare a catalog of top 10 best practice in testing and a starting point for the following actions. I'd like to share them here. The first graphic, in the first graphic, we can say that we can see that more or less half the companies have testers in a full-time effort. Resources can be, you can see that no problems with resources at testing, but when you ask them when they think about testing, you know, you can see that more or less the similar are in at requirements definition or after coding. But we think that's not very, very real, very true, because the other answers. When finish the test, what criteria is used? In this case, more than 35% answer that when tester says it's okay, the test finished. But it's a problem because what is the criteria of tester? It depends on the deadline of the project, their boss. We don't know. But this is the criteria they use. In this graphic, we can see the what is on average, of course, the percent of effort and percent of budget for testing with respect to the total of the project. Here we can see that the 80% of the enterprises use more or less the 25% in testing, and in the other side, only 20% of enterprises use the effort, the same effort, around 30% of the budget and effort of the project. This is one of the more representative in our project graphic, because we can see that there is not a lot of knowledge about testing techniques or different testing methods in an enterprise. None of them are used as a good practice inside the enterprise when they are testing. Here we can see the different levels of testing we practice. Is not very representative because it's similar in all of them possibilities. But here we can see that it's very surprised that functional testing is the more budget we enterprises use in testing. Functional testing, but not effort, and we don't know if it's because use some tools, some functional experts. They use enterprise outside the own enterprise. We don't know. Here we can see the different tools they use to test automation, and here we can see that the more used are GUnit, GMeter, or Jenkins, but we don't know if we can consider GUnit as a test automation tool, or is something more for development, for the construction phase, not the testing phase. Here we can know what's the value perceived of test automation tool. Time saving is possible the more important thing, but we result that test generation cost saving is the second one. And it's significant for us because they thought in that situation that automation tools are magic. They are doing all of them. For ISMI, the cost and the fault of resources are the more important things or barrier to adopt testing tools. But it's a problem because they think that their recourse, if they are using into testing, they are not using in another thing in a project, and it's a problem because now what are they doing? How they are doing everything? Next graphic is very representative too because they are testing. Or they say so, but there is not metric around the test coverage, no metrics, and of course there is not KPIs used for software quality. We think that was a problem because they are testing, but they are not what's the quality of that testing. Here we can see the principal, the main conclusions in this project. We can highlight this one, teach programming so that it can be tested, de acuerdo? So we need to program because someone is using that to testing. Okay, I think it's an important to highlight in these conclusions. The other one was an important challenge, open challenge for Tool and Vendor Academia is reduced to the gap between academia and industry. We need to have testing methodologies that are applicable in the industry from the requirements to generate the test case. We did a top 10 best practice in order to help an enterprise to begin at use a good testing. Saying that testing is not a phase, is a project, a world project. Establish a plan for testing because if you don't have a plan, you never testing. Control and monitor testing activities. Measure the cost, coverage, result, and effectiveness of the test. It's important to know that you are using testing in a good way. Train and manage a test team. It's a very, very big problem here. The people in enterprises has not a good training in specific techniques about testing. Provide tools and a support infrastructure. Try soon, try often, and above all, try all of them. Lean on existing techniques, standards, or models, design and develop for testing, and associate test results with project progress. It has been 6 years. During the following years, we work individually and in ad hoc projects with those companies which have come to ask for advice. But in this time, we realize that the same barriers, challenges, and limitations still maintain. I like to think about them. The first of the conclusion is that the testing situation in a small and medium enterprise is far away from being an it. On the one hand, we observe a lack of testing profiles, and it still exists today. In a small and medium enterprise, this profile is not very popular. It seems that the person who is in charge of giving the approval of the quality of the software product is considered that the last link in the chain. In many cases, it's out of the project, and the people who work in these jobs have neither experience nor technical or functional knowledge, and this area to provide the necessary value. Testing is far from being considered a priority in the day-to-day life in a small business. In fact, one of the values that sell is closeness and to the customer and close response to any issue, assuming that they will exist without proposing anything more. Here, it will be necessary to make a marketing campaign for the new professional through the universities, demonstrating that importance and value of this work. There are many IT professionals in demand today, and software and small enterprises taking into account that in many cases the same person can act with different roles, they must be aware of the importance of testing. On the other hand, the lack methodological framework. They are overwhelmed by everything that exists, and they have reference model to compare themselves with, even if the comparison is not entirely good. In this sense, in some way, having something similar like CMMI was for processes would be a great support to know where to start. This is our first recommendation. The other one is the second conclusion is that testing automation is searched, but in many cases is almost as an internal marketing level to say that a tool is being used. You don't work on thinking about what want to automate. One of the sentences that most caught my attention in this time, which I have heard on several situations, if we think we won't get there. That is, we need to change this mind. The important thing is to do many tests or say that many tests are done, but actually unnecessary test cases are executed many times. Automation is important, but not only after a process of knowing what you want to do. And the last one, the third, is finally the large gap that exists between academia, understood as university and research centers, with great advances in testing and companies, the advances of not reach the industry, especially when it comes to a small organization that don't know how to start. They don't know how to eat the elephant. Here are different models of innovation come into play, but also the ability to make practical the knowledge and the advance that are being achieved. In fact, research could be benefit from this feedback from small companies, which will allow them to have lines of work closer to the daily reality. We continue working to improve the quality of software products. Today, when a computer failure or a cybersecurity attack problem can cause chaos in companies such as banks, but also in government agencies, and all this start from the first link. And thanks for all. I don't know if you have any questions.
Hola, I love the last slide. it was really good.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for your presentation. I think that you show us mainly very important conclusion that comes from the trenches. So now I would like to ask to the participant, if you have any question for Laura, you can write at the chat. No questions? Okay, I know the project very well, Laura, as you know. Oh yes, we have. So I am going to read it, okay? One from Alejandra.
Okay.
Say, hey, Laura, do you know what's the proportion of these companies that use agile development methods?
Wow. It's I heard return.
Okay, perhaps it's for my microphone. I'm going to mute.
Okay. Well, that's a good question, because everybody say that use agile development methods, but in trenches, we can see that nobody use that kind of methodologies, because they like to say agile because they don't document, they don't say anything about bureaucratic, but I think that they are using very many methods, but not agile methods very well. I don't know if it's understand.
Yes, in fact, Alejandra continues her sentence telling that if the tester is the last person of the change, even outside of the project, it seems that they are not using agile methods. If you want, Laura, I can complete your answer, because I know some companies that you have it.
Yeah, but when I say that is the last person of the chain, I don't say is the last person in a specific phase or time. Is the last person in the importance in the project, because. How say that? But always we have the no technical person with testing, only with some years of experience, but not a lot of knowledge about the product, the software product. We think that is important. Think that testing is the most important moment in the construction of that software product, because they need to know the requirements, the area of application, and so is some different difficult or technical problems to say this is for that and this is for that. I think people in enterprises don't have this same thinking. They are saying that you can use something to put that and try to see that it is wrong or it's well, but it's not the importance of we want to have to testing.
Thank you. In any case, Laura, I think that some of these companies say that they apply agile,
yeah.
But later is not really true. I think.
No. They have a classical waterfall, of course.
Okay, we have another question from Aitor Arrieta. He says, thank you for the interesting presentation, Laura. Did you find any needs for reusing regression test optimization techniques, such as text selection or test priorization?
Yes, I don't know if they know exactly what are regression techniques, because more of them, they don't know a lot of things about techniques. And when say regression, I think they use something, but not a lot of needing that, I think is they don't know exactly what different techniques about regression or another techniques of testing they have. They need a lot of training about different methods, different tools, different technologies. Here is a big area of knowledge, and the situation of the gap between academia and enterprises is bigger.
I think, Laura, that this gap is bigger even more in between academia and SMS companies than from academia to big companies, or is more or less the same? Do you think that this gap depends on the size of the company?
I differ.
It's very bad in any case.
Well, in my experience, because I don't know all of the big companies, but it's different because in a big company you can have a specific department of testing, but if you know, some companies have this department, but they don't use this department for their projects. And I think sometimes it's very marketing situation about testing. Okay, in small and medium enterprises, we can see a person who is analyzing, they are coding, they are testing, but they don't have more time and they don't have a training or a specific knowledge about testing. They have a different situation. I think in big enterprises, we have the same problem, but the cause, the origin is different.
Thank you. We have another question from Breno Miranda. Mm-hmm. He said, thank you, Laura, for the nice talk. In slide 18, mm-hmm. I was surprised to see the low budget effort for regression testing when compared with the other testing strategies. Do you have any intuition that could explain that result? Few regression cycles, perhaps?
I think it's similar to the last answer, because I think they don't know what's regression testing. They don't have many training about testing. I don't know if it's similar in other, I know that it's not, but people who programming in our enterprises, one of them come from the university, but more of them don't have this knowledge, these grades or so. And for example, in University of Zaragoza, who is the main source of programmers here, they don't have a specific questions about testing in their grade. They don't have enough knowledge to do that. And this is the problem from different techniques. They know that functional testing is something that they can do, but the client can do that. A lot of times, sometimes these testing are made in client side in situ. And I think it's an error, because they can see that it's a problem for them. They don't use requirements to obtain a good requirements and a good validation cases and so on. If you the person who does the functional testing is client, you have a very important problem. But It's typical functional system. Functional testing is the more uses technique of testing, but they don't know what's regression or stress, they don't know these techniques.
Sorry, because I have some delay because I have to move my screen. Okay, we have now another question from Chin Chi Chiung. He said, thank you, Laura, for the nice sharing. Do SMS use automatic test generation tools like Randup or EvoSuite? Do you think if these tools are useful to SMS for the regression testing? What are the major obstacles for SMS to adopt these tools?
I don't know how use these tools specifically, but I think that every testing tools can be used in all enterprises, big or smaller mediums. The problem is how use these tools. If you use the tools when you need use the tools, not expecting or nor waiting for they are magic and the solution of all, you can use these tools. I think it's important for this kind of tools to adapt them to a specific situation of a very, very little company when you need to train the use of the tool and the use of the how their test case are put in the tool. I think it's an important thing to do in vendors that the adaptation to small enterprises are important to use that.
Okay, thank you. Javier Tuya has done another question. Say, thank you for your nice presentation. What do you think that may be the most important barrier for SMEs? Companies managers culture, lack of testing specialists, the client science, others?
All of them. And in a mixer, and you can, because there are many excuses to don't use testing. The most important, I think, is a lack of knowledge about testing in managers. Because if they don't have a steering manager, a steering sponsor in management, they don't use testing. Because when you are developed, you construct something. Testing is seen like something that eliminate, erase all of them and redo, no? And I think the more important thing you can change is the of testing here in a sponsorship. It's like similar our CMMI in all area process area, they need to have a balance between ROI, return of investment, and the use of the process area is similar. But you need the sponsorship of management to do a good program or improve software program improvement. Is similar. I think if we can have a model similar to CMMI and a way for to establish, I don't know, a metrics, KPIs, to establish the sponsorship in management, we have low the barriers.
Thank you, Laura. More questions? No? Okay, I have some questions, Laura. As you can imagine. Okay, now if I am not in a mistake, I think we are 26 people in the room.
Okay.
We are among friends, okay? So I want to do some personal questions to you. Okay, I am asking to Laura García Borgoñón, okay?
Okay.
It's about the STEAD project. Mm-hmm. As you know, I was invited to some session of the STEAD. Yes. I enjoy a lot with these sessions. Mm-hmm. I would like to ask to Laura, what is your overall evaluation of the project about the experience? Are you happy? Are not happy? What do you think about it? I want to know your personal feeling. Please don't be politic, okay? We are okay. Between friends, okay?
all of these projects, I like it very much because we can touch the situation. You can know a lot of people, different enterprises, different problems, different situation. It's very good. In this project in concrete in Testea, with only 1 year of execution, different like SOF Aragón, we in SOF Aragón we were 6 years or so. Here we have only 1 year. I think it was very short. I would like to have more to help enterprises to have more experience in testing, but because we think that it was only the first step, but they want to go more through. But now I don't know if it's a possibility to continue the program Testea. It's something supported by the government, and that's a problem. But my experience is good because we can know a lot of things about enterprises.
Okay, so a second question. Do you think that you personally or the team from ITA Innova who executed this project did anything wrong, or do you think that you probably could do anything that may a better results? Because when I stayed in the session, I enjoy a lot as I told, because yeah. I feeling that people from companies were learning in the session that what was the importance of testing,
especially in workshops with universities. Yes, yes. They were surprises with the different things they can see, and it was the first time they can see something like this.
Mm-hmm. If you imagine that you stay again some years ago at the beginning of the stay, do you change anything?
Well, it's possible. I try to obtain more commercial tools because we only use research or university tools, only that. But I think if we can, because they are good for see the different techniques and different ways to do something, but commercial tools have a lot of things they can use in this moment, in this situation or so. I think this gap, we don't cover in that moment, and I would like to have a more session about how use that tools, but not vendors, only the technical that is good for that. We don't have this experience, and I think is the very very special issue they can appreciate.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you. We have one question more from Antonia Bertolino. She asks, which will be a lesson that we as researchers should take from this reality that seems not to have evolved much in the last year or even decades?
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know, because
it's a very good question.
Yeah. I don't know because researcher is very, very, have a lot, very fast. say, and I think it's different careers. One of them is a research, and you are in if you are in top, you can obtain results of different things. But in enterprises are very slow. They are in their business, in their problems, in day-to-day problems. They don't have time to do the change. And the gap is day-to-day bigger than the day before. I think it's very difficult to answer this question.
Okay. And we have one question more from Alejandra. She said, do you know if these companies do any usability testing on their products? Is the reality of usability testing similar to functional testing, or is even worse?
It's even worse. I think they don't use usability testing. Okay, it was in 2015. It's possible that now with the user experience moment, our enterprise are inside because it's more important to know the problem with the eyes of the client in the user experience. It's possible that usability testing have more importance than in that moment. But in my experience, there isn't nothing about usability testing. That's what I was.
Yeah, as I said, that was what I thought. Yes, I think not all of us will have it. Okay, Breno Hacks, in the slide about tools adaptation, the two main reasons for not adopting testing tools, if I remember well, mm-hmm. Well, cost and the belief that the adopting a tool will consume time from the team.
Yeah.
Considering that we have many software testing tools available that are free and second, easy to use, what else is missing to reduce the gap academia industry? Better advising of our tools?
Better advising, I don't know. Advertising for small enterprises is possible, and I think one of thing very important, they need to have a support, a close support to the small enterprises. They need to see you as a
big brother.
Yes, a friend. Oh, I don't can do that. Why I can't? It's not like it's our situation, because when enterprise called me, Laura, I don't know how to do that. Oh, sorry, no problem. We can see, and so that is the solution, or the first step of the solution. You can do that more of that. But okay. But I think the more important thing is they can see you are in their shoes. The empathy, the close or nearest of the advices, I think is the more important for vendors, for tool vendors.
Javier, do you told that maybe we are not able to explain or demonstrate what is the ROI, the return of investment, yeah, of testing.
Yeah.
Really, here is a problem.
But this problem is common in not only testing, it's a problem in requirements. I know a lot of enterprises that don't make requirements. They chat with the client and coding and chat with the client and that's not, they don't have a metric, a KPI, so on to about testing. But I think the problem is not only this. The problem is that a failure in informatics is something accepted for the society. Okay, not all failure. For example, we have a failure in avionics. You say, wow, it's impossible to have this kind of failure. And there are a lot of failures we don't can see. The plane don't crash every failure, software failure. But I think if your system don't go, no problem. If Windows have a blue window, no problem. You restart and go home. And I think it's important thing that I can see the different graphics, but the problem is that no problem with failures in software. If you don't have clients, if you have more failures, you have this problem, and you invest in testing more. It's my opinion.
Okay, thank you. I don't know if we have more questions. We have some minutes left. No? Okay. I love Testea, and I love this kind of discussion between academia and companies. And you are in the middle, Laura. So, but
yes, we are in the middle because we know university, but we are in university.
We're not university. Yeah,
we aren't
close to companies.
Yeah, but we are in the bridge.
Yeah, so, yes, hacks that how may we make case state more accessible to SMEs?
I invite you, all of you, to do workshops, specific workshops for small enterprises. Try to put in their shoes, to think like a small medium and explain the benefits of automatic testing to this kind of enterprises. I think it's a good
self example.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Anything more? No? Okay, so Laura, I think it's time to close it. Thank you very much. Remember that you have a stage after that. Thank you very much for your participation. I think that this keynote is completely different to the keynotes that normally we saw in a conference.
Yeah,
it was the most interesting because in fact with AST this year we want to open our minds to think that we have to try to bring the gap between companies and university. And it's time to put in the shoes of enterprises, as you told. So thank you very much. You are receiving a lot of hands here. Okay, I know Laura very well. She's my friend. I know her for a lot of years, and I know that she's completely open for future questions and so on. So thank you, Laura. It was very interesting. And for all our participants, we will join again tomorrow for continue with our meeting, okay?
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Relax, and we will see you tomorrow. Thank you. Bye-bye, everyone.
Thank you. Bye.